Hey there, energy community. Let's talk about curtailment, or what happens when we can't use all the renewable power that's available. These days, lots of cities, states, and even entire countries are setting goals to decarbonize their power systems, and that will mean building a lot of wind turbines and solar panels. But it also means figuring out what to do with all the energy those solar panels generate in the middle of the day when the sun is at its peak, and the wind energy that's generated in the middle of the night when electricity demand is at its lowest point. You see, when wind and solar represent a small percent of overall electricity generation, it's easy for the grid to use all that renewable power at any time of day, on all days of the year. But at higher levels of wind and solar, there are times when these resources produce more energy than the grid can serve to customers. That's where curtailment comes in. Not all the energy that's generated gets used. And this can happen not just in cases of oversupply, but also when there's a lack of system flexibility, which could mean congested transmission lines, other power plants being unable to reduce their output safely or economically, or other constraints. So, curtailment has gotten a bit of a bad reputation for wasting abundant renewable energy. But we don't have to think of curtailment that way. Think of it like buying a TV cable package or a streaming subscription to any of the streaming services out there. Buying that package knowing you cannot possibly watch all of the programs and thousands of channels available to you isn't all that different from building more renewable power plants knowing we won't always be able to use the energy that they produce. The point is, you have it for the shows you can't miss, and the package gets you the best value in the end. Get it? We're going to need a lot of wind and solar in a super high renewable future, and the best strategy might be to max out our renewable power package so we have enough power for when we really need it, and get comfortable with curtailing some of it so we can maximize its values at other moments. This is nothing new. The grid has always had more power plants than are used most days of the year, because we can't afford not to have that backup power to keep the lights on when we really need it. One reason why renewable curtailment has gotten a bad rap is that it reflects a lost opportunity to sell clean, free electricity. But as the cost of wind and solar continues to decrease, so does the impact of that lost opportunity. And here's the clincher. Curtailed electricity can actually be used to help make the grid more flexible and reliable, making these solar and wind systems even more valuable in the end. It's happening today. XCEL Energy can actively curtail wind generation to support reliability in its U.S. power systems. And First Solar's large-scale PV plant in Chile uses curtailment as a tool to help the grid respond to changing system needs, letting grid operators turn the system's output up and down as needed. So, if we have regulations that discourage curtailment, we'll miss out on all the added benefits renewable power plants can offer. Just like how if you didn't buy that TV package, you'd miss out on that season premiere that everyone is talking about. So the bottom line, when it comes to wind and solar, too much of a good thing is still a good thing. Learn more about our research at nrel.gov.